Welcome one and welcome all, baby, to America's channel, the channel that is on your side. So in this video, I want to share just a few care tips to help you save them. Oh my God, we need to save the orchids. We got to save the orchids. Stay tuned. In today's video, what can we do to save our orchids? The first thing that you can do, even if you don't have electricity, you might have gas. You want to make sure to keep it safe, but turn that gas stove on, baby. Open it up. Let that gas stove warm up at least that one room. Go get you some blankets. Okay, you're gonna make it through. Put all of your orchids in the same room. It's no sun. Put them in the same room. Put them in the bathroom if you have to. Anywhere where there is going to be warm water. Stay tuned. Welcome on back where the struggle is real. Now, I know you got the heat going on blast. Those of you like me that still have heat, thank you, Jesus. Okay, but what you want to keep in mind is that temperature at that window sill. That's why I told you should have got one. You got to monitor the temperature on the window sill. Monitor the temperature on the floor. That's where it's going to be the coldest. Okay, so if you are moving your orchids, make sure you're not just throwing them on the floor. Okay, so this is the distance, at least a foot, okay, away from the window. And if the window temperatures are adequate, which is you really don't want it below 60, okay, on the windowsill, but 57 degrees. The humidity, do what you can. Right now, I'm boiling water. This is a great day to wash some clothes. Probably not. But the main tip and trick, my orchids, they are thirsty. Yes, they is. Yes, it's their watering time. But honey boo boo kitty, this is not the time to water. Definitely not the time to fertilize. Definitely not the time to use tap water. I rebuke it. So I'm boiling water in the other room, right? Okay. Some of you guys, you are not able to boil water, okay? But you got to think outside of the box. Anything in the house, a couple of candles, okay? Get you some of them Orchid Diva candles. Be careful, but anything that you can do. So by putting your orchids together, okay, normally I say that you have to have space between them. But in this scenario, you know, putting them close together in the same room, okay, will keep the temperature up, you know, instead of having them so spaced out. In addition to that, you saw in the other room I had all of the cabinets open. Open up all the cabinets, all the drawers, everything. Open it all up. All of the closets. Open it all up. Because if you let that cold air stand there, okay, it's going to be harder to, protect your orchids from, you know, cold blast inside of your home. Look, I don't have no fan on today. No fan today. Okay? Do what you got to. That's why you need just some grow lights. You don't know when something like this can happen. You don't know. So we're going to do the best that we can, keeping everybody lifted in prayer. And in addition, we are going to do what we have to do to protect our beautiful blooms. Okay, yes, it's my birthday. Yes, Dallas is going through. I just had a conversation about Dallas yesterday. So, baby, when God say touch not my anointing, he means it. So, I hope that this video gave you a little entertainment. I hope that it gave you a little couple of care tips on how to maintain your beautiful orchids indoors, which is the hardest environment. So, all them people out there that got their orchids on trees, girl, what are you going to do? Until next time. Yeah.